Good morning everyone, welcome to online class. So today we are going to read chapter number 7, a story which we have heard already several times, or you might have watched in the TVs, cartoons many a times, or you might have read the story books or comics. Okay, now not exactly this is related to this chapter, but I suppose you must have heard about Lilliput's Gulliver Travels. You know the story where there are tall people, small people. When they enter the city, they look little different, they look weird. So this story is a bit similar to that character. Now let us start the story. The name of the chapter is Gulliver in the Land of Giants. Now here, Gulliver is a person who is a short-heighted person like us. Now our height may not be short, but they are also just like us, a normal person. Due to some reason, Gulliver gets stuck in the land of giants, where giants are living. So giants, though they are very tall, very tall in height, but they are very friendly. Okay, it is not that they are giants, so they will hurt us. It's not like that. They are also friendly, and their height may be almost 10-20 feet high. Now let me clear one more thing. Tall-heighted person are called giants, and short people, short-heighted person, are called as Lilliputs, or also they can be called as dwarf. Okay. Now in this lesson, Brobdingnag is a fictional land. Now fictional means made up stories, or we can say in other words that it is not based strictly on history or fact, but it is a kind of man-made, okay, just a kind of imagination. Now this land is occupied by giants in Jonathan Swift's adventure. The story's main character is Gulliver. His actual name is Lemuel Gulliver, who visits the land that is Brobdingnag. Okay. After the ship on which he is traveling is blown off course. Now as a result, what happens is that he becomes separated from a party exploring the unknown land of a farmer and his family. Okay, now we shall follow the textbook. We shall do the reading. So kindly follow with me. Gulliver's Travels is a famous book of adventure. It was written by Jonathan Swift. Gulliver had many voyages in the sea and faced many uncommon situations. During one of his voyages, he reached the land of the giants. Now, here is an extract of his experience narrated in his own words. Now, Jonathan Swift has written many stories. Now, this story is one among them. The story goes like that. After staying in England with my wife and family for 2 months, I undertook my next sea voyage, which took me to the land of the giants called Brobdingnag. So this is said by the narrator, that is Gulliver. A giant farmer discovered me and took me up on his palm. He was at least 60 feet high and I was just 6. Can you imagine? 60 feet high and the difference between 6 feet high. So, the giant was 60 feet high. After a close examination, he realized that I was a human being like him, only much smaller in size. So, we can just experience as an example that we in our normal life just holding a kind of small insect on our palm. Okay. He tried to speak to me in his language. The sound of his voice was like the sound of thunder. Why it is thunder? Because he was a giant person, and so his voice was also like that. But I could not understand anything. I spoke in English in a loud voice. He carried me near his ears. But it was of no use. We could not understand each other's language. The farmer took out his handkerchief, doubled it and laid it on his palm. He put me on it and walked on. I couldn't stand due to the movement of his hand. So I lay at my full length. Then he covered me with the ends of the handkerchief and took me home. So it was just like carrying a bottle wrapped in a cloth, isn't it? So after reaching home, what happens? Let us see. The farmer called his wife. She too was a giant woman like him. She was 60 feet high. He showed me to her. At first, she screamed and ran back frightened, as if seeing a spider or lizard. It took her husband a long time to remove her fear. She watched my behavior and slowly began to touch me and lift me. She behaved very kindly with me. So, the farmer's wife couldn't believe that I was a human being. She thought Gulliver, she thought Gulliver as a kind of an spider or lizard. Okay, so she was scared to touch. Then afterwards, the farmer made her to understand, and then she believed. It was lunchtime, so all the people in the family took their seat at the table. The farmer and his wife lived with their three children and an old grandmother. There was only one good dish of delicious food, as I could smell. It was on a huge plate of about 24 feet in diameter. The table was 30 feet high. The farmer put me on the table. I was terribly frightened and kept as far as I could from the edge of the table. The farmer's wife placed some food before me. I bowed low to the farmer and his wife. Farmer and his wife and began to eat. All were delighted to see me eat. Then the mistress sent her maid to fetch a small medicine cup. It held about 3 gallons of drink. I lifted the cup in both hands with great difficulty. Then in a most respectful manner, drank to their health. The drink tasted good. I spoke out words loudly in their praise. It made them all laugh heartily. I almost fainted with the laughing noise. So you just can imagine when the giants are laughing all together, they were five, and how will the noise be? So I was almost fainted. That means Gulliver was very, very much amazed to listen to the voice. Now the farmer made a sign for me to come to his side. As I walked, I tumbled against a crust of bread and fell flat. I got up at once and saw that the good people were all standing around. I took my hat, waved it over my head and bowed low 3 times. They were glad to see that I was not hurt. So he showed his gesture in that way. Just then the youngest son of the farmer, a boy of 10, took me up by the legs and held me in the air. I was shaking all over with fear, but his father snatched me from him and scolded him for his bad manners. When we were halfway through the lunch, their pet cat jumped into the lap of the mistress. Hearing the purring nose of the cat, I turned my head. The animal was 3 times the size of an ox. You have seen an ox, isn't it? So you can just imagine 3 times the size of an ox. Its frightening look made me tremble. Tremble means just he started shivering. Okay. I could not move out of fear. 3 dogs of the farmer also came into the room for the leftovers. Leftovers means the food which was left out after having the lunch. One of them was a mastiff, the size of 4 elephants, and the 2 others greyhounds, somewhat taller than the mastiff but not so big. When the lunch was almost over, a nurse came in with a year-old baby in her arms. The baby stretched his hand towards me. The mistress took me up and gave me to him. The baby caught me by the middle and pushed my head in his mouth. I screamed so loudly that he became frightened and let me drop. The mistress held out her apron to save me from injury from falling down. After lunch, the farmer went back to his field. From his voice and gesture, I knew that he gave his wife instructions to take good care of me. They had a daughter about 12 years old. She was about 40 feet tall. She was an expert with her needle and made fine dresses for her dolls. She and her mother made a bed for me in the doll's cradle. They put me in the cradle and put the cradle on a hanging shelf for fear of rats. The rats were large as mastiffs and much more nimble and fierce. Their tails were about 6 feet long. The farmer's daughter was very kind. She made clothes for me, but their clothes were coarse. Okay, coarse means it was rough. She also washed my clothes. She taught me their language. When I pointed to something, she would tell me its name in her language. I repeated the sound 2 or 3 times. In a few days, I was able to ask for whatever I wanted. She gave me the name of Little Man. She looked after me with a lot of care. She never left my side as long as I was there. I called her the Little Nurse. So, you can see that after some time, they had a good bonding between the giant family and Gulliver. Okay, so it's written very simple in a simple way. I hope you might have understood. Thank you.